Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another session of Gomer Gaming. Doing Warcraft Shadowlands. We're going to start out today by checking a couple of dailies with the two maxed out characters. We want to see if there's any gear upgrades from a couple of quick dailies, and then we'll hop on to Torinya and progress a little bit more through the storyline. Hop on Turkey Pot Pie here. I've had this character since vanilla. He's one of the oldest active characters in Paranold on Warcraft. Handy Notes Legion. Let's shut those off. Make sure those aren't bugging on me. There we go. All right. So if you were following last time we were on, we were having some issues with performance. A lot of drop in frames and just not running very well. And the issue we were having was actually that the fans on my video card, I have upgraded from the stock MSI fans to a pair of high-pressure Noctua 120mm fans. They came unplugged. And so my video card was operating, both running the stream and running the game, with absolutely no active cooling whatsoever. And so, definitely a shout out to MSI's 1000 series cooling, with the twin frozer cooling stack on there. It was kind of keeping up, so definitely a good little card. I did recently put a new thermal compound in there, so I think that was probably what was keeping it surviving, but it was running at about 90 degrees C, so it was starting to downclock a little bit, which is why we were having so many performance issues. With the demands I was putting on it, it just couldn't keep up. But plug the fans in, everything cooled back down, we've got the details cranked way back up again, the stream. Ever since then, it looks like it's been running nice and smooth. Had almost no drop frames after like 4 hours. I had like 120 drop frames over 4 hours, which is great performance. So definitely a big improvement over what we were dealing with before. Oh, I wonder if we can beat these guys. Let's put those in. Send that out. Okay. Now we'll run back over here a little bit, away from folks. Check dailies real quick. Now I could be going around getting a lot of these commendation medals and the anima. That does help a lot. Most of what I'm trying to do now is just getting more and more characters leveled up and checking to see if there are armor upgrades that I could just buzz out really quick and get that'll, you know, help me out in the long run. So far, no armor upgrades popping up for TPP. But that is all right. No dailies in this area. Okay, we'll change characters here really quick. Hop on Linden. Still getting a handy notes thing. Not sure why. Okay. lots of anima to be had out there right now. But that is about it. Okay, doesn't look like we got any quick dailies, so we'll go ahead and hop out of there. Get back on Torinya and see about moving a little bit more through the storyline. Now, evidently this is something I have to do on every single character. Okay, we have moved our way up through Bastion. Does look like I need to go back, and we need to do this quest here. If it'll be faster, probably just be faster to run over there. There is an entire quest chain in this area, and then a quest chain in this area that we need to do before moving up into this area, because this will spread me around, especially after the pier. And then once this area here is opened up, then we'll be sent to Maldraxus, the next area. So we want to go ahead back and get these. They're not pertinent to the storyline, but they are some fun side quests. They do give us a little bit of information about some history and whatnot, and I'm always a big sucker for lore, so we like to pick up those side quests. Okay, I'm going to take a moment. We're going to stop the stream for just a second, but I'm not going to be getting out. I'm going to change one setting on there to see if I can't improve the quality of the stream ever so slightly. Right now I've got it set at 30 FPS. I'd like to see if we can run it at 60 FPS without any issues, since we've got our hardware stuff figured out. So we'll be back in just a quick moment. I'll adjust that setting, and we'll be right back on, so don't go anywhere. Okay, back live. I've got it set to 60 FPS, so hoping it stays a little smoother. I know the 30 FPS in this game can look a little chunky as you move around. And since the machine itself is easily capable of running everything on ultra for this particular game, you know, when the fans are actually plugged in, I want to see if internet can handle being able to run that 60 FPS, because it should. Monitoring temperatures, I've got some boost stuff going from the motherboard software. And so we shouldn't have any problems keeping up. For anybody who is interested in the hardware side of things when it comes to computers and gaming, my daily driver is powered by AMD. It is an AMD 3950X 16-core 32-thread processor. It is self-boosting to over 4.7 gigahertz. And in fact, it's hitting 4.65 to 4.69 on half of its processing cores. So I seem to have gotten a pretty decent chip with the silicone lottery there. This is not overclock. This is just motherboard boost. This is an automatic thing. I have not told it to do anything. I did boost a few voltages here and there for system stability. That's an issue on this particular series of Asus motherboard. But we've got that all ironed out. 32 gigabytes of 3600 speed RAM. It is a little slower on the timings. I've found that with the 3000 series processors, you can run really fast clock speed as long as your timings are a little looser on the memory. And so this is a nice stable setting that I have, and it allows this processor to game a little bit better than it normally would. In the future, I will be gaming on a 5600X processor instead of the 3950X, just because it is able to hit extremely high clock speeds. It's a 6-core 12-thread chip, but I will only be using it for gaming, and the 3950X will be kept in a sort of rendering rig. I'll use that rig to play Warcraft still, but for things like my iRacing, stuff that really likes the high FPS, we will be using that 5600X. That way we can run triple 144Hz monitors, which will be nice and glassy smooth for the iRacing experience, because the smoother it is, the better experience you have with high-speed games like that. So that'll be our goal here in the future. I will hopefully be doing some filming of the rig that I'm actually building all of this in. It'll be two complete high-end gaming systems in one tower. And in previous streams, I've spoken a little bit about this. The tower itself has been completed. It will fit two full ATX, no miniature boards here, two full ATX systems matching ASUS Tough Plus X570 motherboards. Both of the chips will be cooled with matching Noctua NHDU15 stack coolers with dual 140mm fans. They're a dual stack cooler. They are massive. Both of the chips will be cooled with those. Both of the video cards will be cooled with static pressure Noctua 120mm fans instead of the stock graphics card fan configurations. I have found that this severely increases the cooling capacity, and you're able to run the fans at a lower RPM because they just have so much more cooling capability than the stock skinny fans that come on the video cards. Yes, it does make the card very chonky, but in a setup like this, I have all the room in the world. I'll have a Elgato capture card in the streaming, or the big rendering rig, so that it can capture footage and whatnot as I game. And so I'll be able to run stuff at really high settings all the time, even on the stream. The stream will be able to set it really high settings, and that way you guys on your end will get the best possible picture, the smoothest frame rates, and just make the overall experience a little more enjoyable on your end. This series of quests is pretty interesting. It's fun.
How may I assist you? It was my pleasure. What knowledge do you seek? I exist to answer all your questions. How may I assist you? It was my pleasure.
You are seen. Go in service.
Speak, mortal. Mortal.
Yes.
would appear I need to go ring the bell again to get sent back in, since I'm not done with the portals. Note to self, finish the portal stuff first. There we go. Buzz out here and get this. Okay.
Our duty is true. Our purpose pure. Trust the path.
I'm gonna kill this one again. That's all right.
What knowledge do you seek?
Okay, completed that one. Learned a little history. Now, we're going to go deal with some armory creatures. Remember the other day we asked this lady here if she needed some help. She said her friend down the way could use some assistance.
What is on your mind? May we lift each other. What shall we learn from each other? By the Archon's will.
Now, part of what we're doing here is we're putting some of these creatures out of their misery. There is so little anima to go around that the creatures are actually suffering. And since there's nothing we can really do, we're putting them down is the best way to go for them. Collect some toys for the beast up there. She gets a little bored. Ooh, get. See if I can get my butt kicked here. You have to summon the golden cloud feather pet. Aww, him's a little cutie. Excellent. Okay. Let's get back to the duty at hand. I like to hit up those rares when I can. Poor creatures out of their misery, collected a new pet, collected all of the toys. Time to go turn in.
We walk this path together. I wish you enduring resolve. Go in service. May you succeed in your trials.
Silly kitties want their toys.
What knowledge do you bear? By the Archon's will.
Looks like we're going to get a little bit of an upgrade here.
I wish you enduring resolve.
Best things about being a rogue is you get to save your rested bonus without having to kill your way all the way into quest objectives. Can tend to stretch things a little longer that way. You gotta slap the cat around a little bit to get her to learn her lesson. Silly kitty.
It is an honor. Go in service.
Okay, slight upgrade there. I think we're going to take a moment here. Go through our items. Recommend spending the money on this particular mount. It's about 10,000 gold from a vendor, but you can repair and sell anywhere where you can summon a mount. And as you can see, we are emptying out half of our bags and getting a significant amount of gold in the process. Let's see. So far today, we've earned 1,620 gold. So, very easy to earn in the newer portions of the game. Alrighty, let's see here. Wanted the Umbral Plume. Let's go and clear out the area for this one. If I remember right, it's a bunch of nested creatures. You want to clear those out and then blow the whistle to summon a creature. Well, we just suddenly took a little bit of a lag spike there. Not sure what that was about. Connection quality just suddenly plummeted to nil and then jumped right back again. You can see there's a lot of these padding creatures here. Do you want to take care of this? And skinning them doesn't do any good. You don't get any boosts or anything like that. The Umbral Plume. a rather nice chunk of experience. So let's go ahead and travel across. If I remember right, I think the quickest way to get over there is actually to take the teleporter up through the village up on the up there. Just because there's a big hole in the way. There's a hidden thing back here and some treasure. Nothing there. Oh well, I guess maybe we'll stop back by on the way up. In the meantime, we'll work our way down here to go after this big bird. Recall that one being quite so nasty. Yep, I think we'll have to do that one when we have a little bit more oomph or some other folks show up. Unfortunately, not too terribly many people out questing today, which is unfortunate. First couple times I did that one, in and out and on the road. However, ooh, I need to buy some thread. Number thread. I don't know if my vendors on here would carry that or not.
All prices here are reasonable.
Looks like Eternium is the highest that we go on our mount. That's too bad. Okay. Now let's go ahead and head back up to the town there. We'll turn in the one, buy a little bit of thread so I can be working on leather skills. The leather gear that you are able to make once you hit level 60 is pretty good gear. And it is enough to get you into the dungeons. And it's not crazy enough to make to where it's, you know, just a giant pain in the butt.
It is an honor. Clear skies, full hearts, can't lose.
I think it's going to take me quite a while before I replace the Shroud of Resolve. I was able to boost that one fairly far. During the Battle for Azeroth. Okay, steward summoned. I summoned a steward.
Yes? My pleasure.
For what purpose do you light the beacon, aspirants?
Polymark, we have urgent news for the Archon.
You are the ones from the Temple of Purity. Very well, then. You are seen. Proceed with courage.
Finally, an audience with the Archon.
Remain humble.
We shall meet you there, my friend.
I am the Archon's will. The Paragons have already assembled and await the Archon's arrival. It would be wise for you to listen until asked to speak. Such an illustrious audience is a rare honor, mortal. Do not squander it.
Her memories are unequivocal, Devos. Your hand has sworn herself to the Maw.
Lysonia, I never knew darkness lurked within her.
Stay true to our eternal charge.
This is dire news, Visiphone. But the Archon has turned a deaf ear to such tidings in the past.
The circumstances have changed. Tell me of these forsworn.
Most have merely lost faith and may yet be redeemed. But some have fallen so far as to wield the power of the Maw itself.
It is true. This mortal has fought against Ascended who are in service of the Jailer. Lysonia is not the only one.
We do not know when or where the Forsworn will strike next. But strike they will.
What you speak of is unthinkable. But we must remain vigilant nonetheless. Paragons, return to your temples. Adrestes, monitor the wards. It appears you have a part to play in all of this, mortal. Let us see what comes of it. Go in service.
What troubles you? Wisdom guide your path.
Good. The Temple of Loyalty's ward is active. The Kyrian, meditating on their duty to Bastion and the Archon, are safe.
Peculiar. The ward of purity is disabled. This is surely what allowed the Forsworn to invade in such force.
Humility's ward stands strong. However, perhaps it would do the Forsworn service to relearn the lessons taught there.
The past memories of all Kyrian are stored at the Temple of Wisdom. I am quite relieved to see its ward holding. The ward of courage holds. That is quite the relief.
Fools! The Forsworn will triumph over the Archon!
Quickly! We must alert the Polemarch!
By the Archon's grace. Cassius will provide you with a Larian. Go, quickly!
Yes, Polemarch. Archon watch over us all.
You are seen. Trust the path.
The Forsworn who destroyed the ward. He was the one from Lysonia's memories.
It seemed that their pact with the Maw was kept secret from him. I wonder, are the other Forsworn also unaware of it?
The ward has been sabotaged, as we agreed.
Good. Our allies are eager to strike.
The Kyrian temples will fall, and the Archon's reign shall be ended.
I am glad to see I am not yet alone. The Maldraxi attacked without warning. By Xandria's spear. My life for the Paragon.
You betray your ancient oath to Maldraxus, Lich! Justice will be done! Push forward and secure the temple!
You speak to the hand. By Xandria's spear.
Friends, I bring aid!
You have my attention. Keep your wits about you. Our enemy has no honor.
Oh, good questions only. The sooner you find those parts, the sooner this Colossus can help clear their flyers.
Save every Kyrian that you can.
Shoot off a portion of their anima. It will heal your wounds if you approach it. Anima powers all things in Bastion, even the mighty Colossi. This will help it retain its charge.
normally, that would have been pretty good stuff for someone who's just questing through. But since we were fairly far into the end world last expansion, we've got some pretty good gear going on.
This is one of Mechanikos' finest creations. It channels anima directly into blasts of energy.
Maldraxus! Thor is truly powerful if his magic penetrated this plating. He will not go down easily.
hand.
Intriguing weapon. May I inspect?
You won't survive this.
You have my attention. We shall all meet at the shattered span below once our work is done.
Loud and clear. I will just move the Colossus.
Somehow.
Forget to
use. I have sheared off a portion of their anima.
It will heal your wounds if you approach it.
Let's break some bones.
You're my way up the ladder.
Ah!
my way up the ladder!
Have gathered at the Shattered Span. I shall meet you there.
I am a busy steward.
The Colossus needs to finish charging. Buy me time!
You speak to the hand. He has gone towards the Paragon! You have my attention. My life for the Paragon. You speak to the hand. You have my attention. The Paragon of Courage was at the heart of the temple when the attack came. If she yet draws breath, we must lend her our aid.
You cannot win this battle, Necromancer! Our courage never falters.
It will take more than courage to save you now.
My Paragon! You do not stand alone!
Ah! Just the vessel I require.
For the Archon! For Bastion!
What are you doing to me?
No! No! No!
Thanatos!
I have perfected you! Now serve me by destroying our enemies. Yes, Master.
Madness.
You, Kirin, are
completed in a broken cycle. Bastion
not
is a waste of energy.
Stand against you.
Then you will be the next to fall.
Good Paragon! I failed you.
You will suffer for this, Necromancer.
Come, then, if you dare.
Rain death upon them. Ensure they do not interfere.
Outsider, we need to get out of here.
The Paragon can stand on her own until you gather reinforcements.
Artemide will report to the Archon. We must return to Ouroboros and inform them of Maldraxus' treachery. My blade is always ready. We must travel to Ouroboros at once. My people will surely prepare our armies for retaliation once Artemide delivers word. I will meet you there. Stay safe.
Did my brother send you? May your courage never falter.
Wish I'd have seen that before killing the guy. I'd have got credit for it. Oh well, that's alright. Let's see here. I do need to go to Ouroboros. I would like to pick up supplies, get some leather working done. We have crammed some levels today, quarter of the way through 54, so nice boost today.
Peace be upon you. May wisdom guide.
Back to Ouroboros.
Thank you.
for you.
I offer only the finest. Until our next transaction. How may I assist? Please, do see me again.
Now, I think what I'm going to do, we're going to go park next to a mailbox. I'm going to hop on Linden really fast, because I do believe she has a decent amount of leather on her.
Interesting. You have a great day now.
Okay. So. Jumpy really quick. And all of that. This is what's nice, being able to get a character boosted in level quickly. You can use them to kind of support your other characters and make their level experience a little nicer.
Well, then.
Right. Rearrange things here. My kitty's coming to see me. Aren't you, kitty?
You honor me with your attention.
Okay. Got us about where we can get for now. That's heavy desolate leather, which we don't have a use for quite yet.
This realm offers infinite opportunities.
Okay. Well, we've created a little bit of gear. It's given us a boost.
At your leisure. Remember the lessons of the past.
hear the words of the Arbiter.
This is most dire news. We must not let war ravage this plane and unravel all that we have done.
The Necrolords are masters of warfare, it is true. But they have always used their power to defend the Shadowlands, not attack it. Mortal, you must learn their motives for striking at the Kyrian. Do whatever it takes to stop this conflict before it escalates further. Without the might of Maldraxus on our side, I fear we have little hope of stopping the Banished One. What news do you bring? The way to Maldraxus must be opened. Gather Cardalene and see it done.
At once, honored voice.
And this point, we're going to take a short break. Need to get myself a little bit of grub. But probably be jumping back on here shortly. So keep an eye out. And we are back.
It's settled in here.
Get a diet beverage. Gotta maintain my girlish figure. Pizza cooking in the air fryer. I'm going to make for a fantastico meal. Crispy pizza. Thank you.
I hope this endeavor is successful. There is still little anima available.
That's it. Lucky do's and loot. Good fortune to all
the
friends of the Grummels.
The purpose must be followed. Instructed to assist you. Blessed be her voice.
You are welcome here.
Thank you.
training! If you want to fight, then Maldraxi, why are you still in here? Grab a blade and enter the arena! Grab a weapon and get in line! I dwell! All of Maldraxus is watching! Another challenge of holes! some fish meat today. Champions on board.
Thank you.
new weapon and get in line. Clear the arena! The final clash is about to begin! Nothing sweeter than the sound of combat. Only two gladiators remain. One legend will grow, and the other will end.
Chosen stands with you. No time for talk. We move now.
Baroness Draka, you might remember. From the film Warcraft.
We can't get away! Brace yourself! Always ready for battle. Even
come.
Here, this is our only path to the House of the Chosen. Strength comes from the heart. Maldraxus is home to those who live or come. Here, strength is balanced and rewarded. The sworn defenders of the Shadowlands, but our leader, the Primus, has gone missing. Goes the fight. For pressure or after it. Now, the five houses are at war. Two have fallen. I won't let the Chosen be next. Bromka. For the honor of the Bladesworn, strength and honor.
Who else do we know that has green skin and says strength and honor all the time? Give you a hint, it's not a peon. It is Thrall. Draka.
Blood and thunder.
Is Thrall's mother.
Every defeat is a lesson. In the name
chosen, fight with strength and honor. We will crush the traitors and end this war.
Chosen. Our enemies move against us. War is at hand, and victory will be ours.
Margrave Crexus is the strongest of us. Show him no fear, only respect.
You did well to pull the mortal from the arena. We could not let our enemies take them.
They have shown resilience and strength, qualities we need. In life, I was Draka of the Frostwolf clan. A warrior who gave everything to protect what mattered most. But I was not done fighting.
Maldraxus, where the armies of the five houses once stood side by side to protect the realm of death. It was here I served the House of Eyes. A strange pit for a warrior's soul.
Again.
Their ways were not mine. Eventually, this life after life began to feel right.
The House of Plagues lies in ruins. One fifth of Maldraxus wiped out.
It's hard to believe they could be so careless.
Perhaps they weren't. No matter what happens now, Maldraxus must stay true to its purpose. For if we fail in our duty, the Shadowlands will fall. I believe the House of the Chosen still stands with us, and I trust you to deliver this to Margrave Crexus. Now, go. Andraka. Be watchful.
My brothers, I am on urgent business. My lord! Hurry! There could be survivors! Prevent me from delivering my lord's final message.
Ordeals such as this either break the sword or strengthen it. I offer the key to saving Maldraxus.
I am sorry, Margrave. He gave me no key.
An unyielding warrior. With the skills of a master spy. A key to many things. Come, our enemies will strike openly soon. We must prepare.
I, Andraka, once of the Frost Wolf clan, now Baroness of the House of the Chosen, and most of all, a protector of Maldraxus.
For the honor of the Bladesworn. Only the strong.
Don't keep Vyraz waiting. He's not known for his patience.
I believe this is where we're going to call it for today. Got a few things to take care of before the racing tonight. If you enjoy online racing or silly shenanigans or both, be sure to tune in tonight at 7:30 Central. Look up Bearded Sim Racer on Twitch, Facebook, or YouTube, and watch the 24 Hours of Lemons doing all kinds of really silly stuff tonight. We're going to be racing cars where they should not be raced, racing cars that should not be raced together, and just generally acting like a bunch of goobers. It's always a lot of fun, lots of yeetage going on, silly paint schemes, and behind the scenes a little trash talking. You guys aren't too privy of that, but rest assured, it's going on. But definitely check us out tonight, 7:30 Central, on Twitch, YouTube, and Facebook. Look for Bearded Sim Racer. And until next time, thanks for watching. Hope to see you next week.